are celebrating or remembering and commemorating Remembrance Day in a very unique and different way this year. We all know how difficult and challenging this time is with the COVID-19 virus, but we need to do everything that we can to keep those of us who are here very safe. So if you're joining us on the filming, welcome. For those who are gonna gather and place your own wreaths and poppies outside, you are welcome. But we are, in the best way that we can, here to remember and to commemorate that sacrifice that people have made for us. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. We meet in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to work, to penitence and faith, for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may together live in freedom, justice, and peace. We pray for all who are in bereavement, disability, and pain, who continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts past and present have been given and taken away. So let us confess in God and to God the sins and shortcomings of the world, its pride, its selfishness, its greed, its evil divisions and hatreds. Let us confess our share in what is wrong and our failure to seek and establish that peace which God wills for all his children. And we say, most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The collect for this Remembrance Sunday. Almighty Father, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of all, govern the hearts and minds of those in authority and bring the families of the nations divided and torn apart by the ravages of sin to be subject to his just and gentle rule, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now we will listen to the readings for this day.
Darlleniad allan o lyfr Rufeiniaid, penod 8, adnodau 31 i 39. Felly, beth mae hyn yn ei olygu? Os ydy Duw ar ein hochr ni, sdim ots pwy sydd yn ein herbyn ni. Naeth Duw ddim, hyd yn oed arbed ei fab ei hun, rhoddodd e'n ambeth i farw yn ein lle ni i gyd. Felly, oes yna unrhyw beth dydy e ddim yn fodlon ei roi ni? Pwy sy'n mynd i gyhyddo'r bobl mae Duw wedi ei ddewis iddo ei hun? Wnaeth Duw ddim. Duw ydy'r un sydd yn ei gwneud ni'n ddieuog yn ei olwg. Felly, pwy sydd yn mynd i'n condemnio ni? Wnaeth y Meseia Iesu ddim. Be ydy'r un gafodd ei ladd a'i godi yn ôl yn fyw? A bellach, mae'n eistedd yn y sedd anrhydedd a'r ochr dde Duw yn pledio ar ein rhannu. Oes yna rhywbeth sy'n gallu gwahanu ni oddi wrth gariad y Mesoea? Nac oes dim byd. Dydy poen ddim yn gallu, na dioddefaint, cael ein herlyd, newid, na noethni, peryglon, na hyd yn oed cael ein lladd. Mae'r ysgrifau sanctaidd yn dweud fel hyn. Oedd achos di, rydyn yn ein gwynebu marwolaeth drwy'r amser, rydyn fel defaid ar ei ffordd i'r lladdu. Ond rydyn ni'n concro'r cwbl i gyd a mwy am fod y Mesoea wedi ein caru ni. Dwi'n hollol sicr fod dim byd yn gallu'n gwahanu ni oddi wrth ei gariad. Dydy marwolaeth ddim yn gallu, na'r un profiad gawn ni mewn bywyd chwaith. Dydy angylion ddim yn gallu, na phwerau ysbrydol drwg. Dim byd yn y presennol, nac yn y dyfodol. Dim byd ymhellderoedd eitha'r gofod, nac yn ymderoedd y ddear. Na, does dim yn y bydysawd yma greodd Duw yn gallu'n gwahanu ni oddi wrth gariad Duw, ein harglwydd ni, y Mesoea Iesu. Dyma ddiwedd y ddarlleniad, clod i Duw.
The second reading is from the Gospel according to St. John, the 15th chapter beginning at the 12th verse. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go out and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give peace. We pray for the service men and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered and known to God. Lord, hear our prayer and give us your peace. For those who love them in death and as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our love. Lord, hear our prayer and give us your peace. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering their families, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. Lord, hear our prayer and give us your peace. For civilian women, men, and children whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatred of humanity. Lord, hear our prayer and give us your peace. For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free. Lord, hear our prayer and give us your peace. For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, that they may have gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. Lord, hear our prayer and give us your peace. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and give us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honor the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. And together we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
There's a reason that we are standing by this grave in St. Michael's Churchyard in Abergele this morning. This lady, Mary Williams, lost her two sons in the Great War on the same day. Unfortunately, she had a telegram at her home in Bryn Tirion in the morning to say that George Trevor had sadly lost his life. About 3 hours later, she had another telegram to say that her other son, Fred, was missing in battle at the Great War. And this holds great significance to myself because it is a family member. Mary Williams was my grandmother's sister. Rydwi'n sefyll wrth y bedd yma, bore yma, yn enwedig bedd teuluol a bedd sydd yn gysylltiad mawr teuluol i mi. Bedd teulu Williams. Mary Williams, mi oedd hi yn chwaer I fy nhaid, a mi gollodd hi ddau fab yr un diwrnod yn yr rhyfel mawr. Oedd hi'n byw yn Bryn Tirion, Abergele, a mi gath hi delegram yn y bore I ddeud bod George Trevor wedi marw yn hyfynder. A rhyw ddwy awr wedyn, mi gath hi neges arall drwy delegram I ddeud bod y mab arall hefyd, Fred, wedi marw. A mae hyn yn gweddiwn. Arglwydd Clywain Gweddi a rho I ni heddwch. I bawb sy'n ysgwyddo baich ar fraint o arweinyddiaeth yn wleidyddol, filwrol neu'n grefyddol. Rho iddynt y gallu a doeth uneb I drafod er mwyn datrys problemau lleol, Cymru, Prydain a'r byd, I gymodi tuag at heddwch. Arglwydd, tegwch a gwirionedd. Cofiwn yr rhai a fu farw er mwyn yr hyddyd rydym yn ei fwynhau heddiw. Diolchwn iddynt. Am y bobl hynny fi'n brwydro mewn rhyfeloedd a fu farw, ein hanwyliaid a'r rhaid I enw. Cofiwn hwy. Cofiwn hefyd am y rhai sy'n parhau I frwydro ac yn marw mewn rhyfeloedd yn y byd heddiw. Cysura ni. Dysga ni fod yn dosturiol ac yn ofalgar, a gwna ni yn ystyriol o anghenion pobl eraill. Uwch law popeth, lle bynnag y clywir ein cri, tynnu at ein gilydd yn enw'r cariad sydd yn dygalon dros yr holl bobloedd, cenhedloedd a'r greadigaeth gyfan. Amen.
Thank you.
In peace, let us remember before God and commend to his sure keeping those who have died for their country in war and conflict, those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of others.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Amen.
In Flanders fields, the poppies blow between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Thank you. here at Eglois Gawisant, the Church of St. David's, to honor those from this area of Pensarn who have lived and died in service for their country and those they love, to assure us of our freedom that we enjoy today.
An act of commitment, and if you will all answer, we will, after the questions that I ask. Let us commit ourselves to be responsible, living, and faithful servants. Will you strive for all that makes for peace in this world? We will. Will you seek to heal the wounds of war? We will. Will you work for a just future for all of humanity? We will. Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope that you have placed in the hearts of all people, and live lives of justice, courage, and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen. And may I offer to you all the blessing of God. God grant to the living peace and grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord. And let us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and those you love, and remain with you always. Amen.